Ryan coming back to you from Pure Vita Fitness. We had a technical difficulty, which is why this is split into two parts. I'll take the total blame for that. It's terrible technology. All right, so back to where we were. We're back on the Liver 11. We are at the fire hydrants. So this one's going to be a hip activation as well as a glute activation. Sorry, I should say hip opening, hip mobility, glute activation. Hands are stacked underneath the shoulder. Knees are underneath the hips. Back is nice and flat. He's going to pick his knee up and make a circle with it from the hip. The biggest circle you can make from the knee, you're going to go 10 forward and 10 backwards. Obviously, you're going to do this on both sides. Trying to make as much movement from the hip as you can, using the knee basically as a head of a pencil to draw the circle. From there, we're going to go on to mountain climbers, okay? Push-up position again. Hands are going to be shoulder-width apart. And we're just going to bring our knee into our chest, hugging our toe off the ground, trying to have no movement from the torso as much as possible. So activate your core by doing that. And obviously, you're going to get a lot of hip and glute mobility here, movement, and then hip mobility, and a lot of glute, quad, and hamstring activation. All right. So after that, we go ahead and move on to the Cossack squats. So we're going to stand up. Then take an extra wide stance. He's going to shift his weight to one side. As he shifts his weight to one side, this toe flexes up to the ceiling. Nice tall torso. His butt should drive back and down over his heels, so our knee is not overly flexed over our toe. You can go one side 10 times, or you can flush back and forth, however you want to do it. Again, 10 is the magic number I like to use. If you feel like you want to do more, feel free to do more. From this, we go to the piriformis stretch. You're going to sit on the bench here. He's going to cross one leg over, ankle over knee, and he's going to go ahead and push down on his knee and his ankle. He's going to lean forward. It's going to create a huge stretch kind of in his hip in the piriformis area. And he's going to either hold it there for about a minute, or you can kind of rock back and forth, whatever you prefer to do. Nothing is wrong with that as long as you're feeling the stretch. The last thing we'll do, the most intense, most likely for most of you, is going to be a super couch stretch. So you're going to take this pad, find a pad if you don't have one, try to find a mat if you have a hard surface. What you're going to do here, come over here, you're going to try to get yourself into an upright position, foot back on the bench. We want this shin angle as vertical as possible, and he's just going to sit back on that heel of his butt. It's going to create a huge stretch down his quad and hip flexion here, and open up the area. You typically want to sit on that for anywhere from 1 minute for beginners, and then 2 minutes once you've done this for intermediate to advanced individuals. Okay? So now you have your Agile 8, which I recommend starting with every day as a workout. And then if once you've done that for a few weeks and you've got it memorized, then we can move ourselves into Limber 11 as we're just adding three new exercises to it. Okay, I recommend doing this every day, especially workout days, off days as well, and then continue to add into your program. Again, Ryan here, Pure Vita Fitness, that is your mobility tips of the week.